Thank you very much for clicking on this vid. Nag-vlog pa ko.
Sabot na ba?
Oh, say hi. Please. Thank you very much for clicking on this video. It's me again, teacher Ada Jules. Hi, A-Team. How are ya? Welcome back to my channel. And if you're new here, welcome. I'm teacher Ada Jules and I post videos about online teaching. So if you want to know more, click that subscribe button below and hit the notification bell so you will be notified every time I post new videos. By the way, if you click the notification bell, just choose all so you will be notified every time I post new videos, especially about online teaching. So you happen to pass by my video because you just passed the initial interview of 5-1 talk. All right, so if you haven't and you're just preparing the stuff that you will need in case you apply, so just click here. I have a video about the actual interview questions of 5-1 talk, so you're gonna need that if you want to apply as a 5-1 talk teacher. So after this video or before this video, you may watch this first. There you go. After you pass, not if, but after you pass the initial interview, you're gonna have your technical check. 5-1 talk facilitators will check your equipment, your technical requirements, if they are fit to be used in 5-1 talk. So in this video, I will share with you what happens during 5-1 talk technical check. After you pass, they're going to give you a set of schedules and you'll choose which schedule is most convenient for you. And after that, you're going to send a message to your 5-1 talk facilitator on Skype. So here are the things that you will need for the technical check. So they're going to require you to send a screenshot of your control panel. So just like this one. They will check if you are really using a LAN cable like this. Alright, so this is a LAN cable and this is very useful because it makes the internet connection more stable and reliable. Aside from that, they will also require you a screenshot with a link of your speed test from speedtest.net. And don't you dare use other screenshots or link because they will really trace that. They will really know if you're lying. Okay, so we don't want that. We don't want that to happen. So just be honest, okay? Because that will also give you trouble in the future if you're going to lie just to be a 5-1 talk teacher. And when you are a 5-1 talk teacher, you will really have troubles when it comes to your internet connection. So it's there for a reason. That happens for a reason, okay? They're going to check if you are really capable, if you, your internet connection, your equipment are really capable to handle lessons and be a 5-1 talk teacher. All these processes are for you. They will also let you download the TeamViewer software. So if you're not very familiar with that, that software will let them control your computer. You will download that and they will give you the password and then voila! They can control your computer. And then they can check your disk space, your OS version, your processor, if you have a PDF reader. They can check everything on your computer. But of course, they're not going to change anything. They'll just check your laptop or your desktop if it's really suitable and capable to handle 5-1 talk lessons in the future. And these are the things that you will need for you to pass the technical check. Okay, first, you need to have a headset with extended microphone like this one. And if you don't have your equipment yet, you just have to click this video and know more about the affordable and recommended equipment for you to be a 5-1 talk teacher. So just click this video if you want to know more about the details of the brand or the kinds of laptop or kinds of microphone or camera that you'll be using. First, you have to have a headset with built-in microphone. Of course, that should have a noise canceling or noise reduction feature. So it looks like this. You cannot use this or this during the technical check because you will surely fail. Next one is the camera. So you can either use this or this. So the camera should have at least 720p resolution. For speed test, for your upload and download speed, it should be at least 5 Mbps for both of them. And your ping must not be high. So the lower the ping, the better. Okay, so let's dig deeper. Your processor should be Intel. I've been repeating this over and over again, but yeah, I'm sorry. Your processor should be Intel Core i3 6th generation. You will see something like this in your processor. i3-6. It should be like that. Or higher. Higher is better. Okay, and if it's i5, it should be 4th generation and above. And i7, 4th generation and above. Intel Pentium and Intel... What is that? Pentium and Core Duo, Core 2, Pentium, and there are a lot, but only i3, i5, i7. And for desktop, it should be AMD A5, A6, A7, A8, and A10. The minimum RAM should be 4GB and your disk space should be at least 100GB. The clock rate should be 1.80GHz or above. And for the CPU benchmark, it should be at least 2000. That's for the Windows. Here's for the MacBook users. The OS version should be 10.11 and above. And it should be 2012 model and above. And the RAM, again, is 4GB. And for the free disk space, it should be 100GB because AC or the Air class, the classroom that we use for teaching, is really heavy and it eats up all your memory. So you really have to have a free disk space. When you have 8GB of RAM, that would be better, even better. And if you pass all of those, congratulations! You're now heading to the interview. Another interview, but it's not really an interview. The facilitator will talk to you that you pass, here are the next step. He or she will give you another set of schedule to follow for the PSO, or the pre-service orientation. But if you fail to comply, don't worry because it's not yet the end. 51Talk is very considerate with the applicants, so they will still give you a chance. They will just put your application on hold, but if you are ready to proceed, you will just have to contact your facilitator or just send them an email. If the things that you have don't pass the technical standards of 51Talk, they will send you a message about what you should do. After all of that, you'll either pass or fail. Of course, we're all hoping for you to pass. So, after you pass, they will contact all of the passers. You're going to have a group call, and then the facilitator will explain the next steps. They will give you a set of schedules, and then you are going to choose which one's most convenient for you. And then you're going to the next level, which is the PSO, or the pre-service orientation. So aside from that, the facilitator will talk to you one by one about your preferred schedule. And the last time that I experienced with my referral was the facilitator asked her to move the camera around, maybe to show if she is really on her own workspace, because maybe she was really thinking that she's on a 51Talk teacher's space. Her equipment is kind of okay. Maybe it's too good to be true for an applicant. So she asked my referral to show the surroundings and she gave her some instructions, and then that's that. But knock on wood, if you fail, because maybe some of your equipment isn't really suitable for 51Talk teaching, don't worry because it's not yet the end. 51Talk is very considerate with their applicants, so they will give you a second chance. If you are ready, you're going to contact the facilitator. They're going to send you a message about the details together with their contact information. You may either send them a message on Skype or send them an email. You may contact them when your equipment is ready, when you're ready to proceed with your application. I really hope you pass the technical check, and of course, I really hope you will also be a 51Talk teacher like me. And that's it for today's video. All right, shout out time! First of all, major shout out to my mom. It's her 50th birthday today. Jimmy Shangri Kwaila! Shout out naman natin si Teacher Kezia Ruth. I subscribed to her channel and I found out that she's also posting about NovaKid. It's also another ESL company. So check her channel out and subscribe na lang din. Thank you so much. Next is shout out to Teacher Joyce De La Peña. She said, "Hi Teach, shout out sa next vlog. Thanks and stay safe." Thank you very much for watching my previous video. Naman is pipili tayo sa mga nagsasend sa atin ng message sa Messenger. Sabi ni Teacher Lai Jin Gringju, is it Legion or Lijen? I'm so sorry. But she said, "Hello, Teach Ada Jules. Thank you sa imong mga videos. Maka-inspire kayo." Thank you, Teacher Lijen. And sabi din ni Teacher Florence Joy Amora Villanueva, "Very informative yung vlogs mo. Please, more videos. More videos pa po. God bless, Teach." Thank you so much. Just know that I always appreciate your messages, especially if you go out of your way and just send me a message. So thank you very much. I appreciate that one. Thank you, A-Team. And I have a Facebook group. It's called A-Team. I'm going to post a picture here. So if you're my subscriber and you want to interact with other subscribers too, just join this group. And it's for free, of course. Just be my subscriber and you're good to go. That's it for today's video. Next video pala natin is I'm going to share with you how I order Shopee via Shopee Pay, because that's Teacher Ella's requested video. So thank you very much. I hope to see you again in my next video. Bye!